crazy Jerusalema. That video went viral. Me and Chris dancing in Jerusalema. So, what do I say in conclusion? This was a man who believed that Kenya is playing in a different league. That Kenya does not deserve to play in the league in which Kenya is playing today. That Kenya can be in another league. And he used to give a very good example of countries that have been able to transition, like Singapore. He really loved to give example of Singapore and Malaysia and Korea. I'm not saying these countries were just as poor as Kenya, but they've managed to transition from poverty to wealth. The example I'll give you is that in 1952, Ethiopia helped South Korea. Ethiopia sent 5,000 troops to South Korea to help South Korea. In 1952, Ethiopia was more developed than South Korea. But then, 60-something years later, the GDP and the per capita income in Ethiopia was still just $300 per annum, when in South Korea it was 19,000. Koreans now go and build schools in Ethiopia. You ask yourself, what happened? And the same thing has happened also to us here in Kenya. We are colonized, but so are Korea and all those other countries. So Kirubi believed that it is possible to transition from poverty to prosperity if you've got right policies. And he was also an enemy of corruption. We talk very passionately against corruption. He says there is a very many ways of making wealth without having to steal. Those who steal, and after stealing that money, then they will run around and give donations to schools in terms of buses, women groups, youth, and then come to churches and donate millions of shillings without saying where that money is coming from. Trace Kirubi hated those people and believed that you can make money without having to steal it. May the Lord bless Chris' soul in eternal peace. Thank you.
Actually, Honorable Raila Odinga probably knew about the dress code was black and red, and I thought that's why he came that way. Let me ask.